Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to discuss a new term in this chapter, that is colloid. What is the spelling? C-O-L-L-O-I-D-S, colloids. Okay. So, the mixture of substances are generally classified into three categories, that is true solution, colloids and suspensions. Okay. So, mixture of substances are generally classified into true solutions, colloids and suspension. Okay, so in this we have to detail studies about colloids. Okay, so first we have to know what is the main difference between true solutions, colloids and suspensions. Okay, so first property, this is properties in this column, and here it is mentioned true solutions, here it is mentioned colloids, and here it is the suspension. So first one is in properties, particle size. Okay, that means in true solution, how much is the size of the particles present in that? So in true solution, the size of the particles is less than 10⁻⁹ meter. 10⁻⁹ meter means what is it? It is 1 nanometer. So the particle size is less than 10⁻⁹ meter or 1 nanometer. That means the particle size is very small. Okay. In case of true solutions. Next, if you are taking colloids, the particle size is from 1 to 1000 nanometer, and it is, we can write in meter, 10⁻⁹ nanometer means 10⁻⁹ meter to 10⁻⁶ meter. That means the colloids are little bit larger than which one? True solutions, because in true solution it is less than 1 nanometer, right? Here it is in between 1 nanometer to how much it is? 1000 nanometer, okay? Then suspensions. Suspensions means it is more than 1000 nanometer. More than 1000 nanometer means it is greater than 10⁻⁶ meter, okay? That means suspension is more having more particle size compared to true solutions and colloids. Okay, so which one is the smallest? True solution is the smallest, and which one is the largest? It is suspension, and colloid is having the particle size in between true solutions and suspension. Then next is filterability. That means how we can, the particles in the true solution, colloids and suspensions, we can filter. How we can filter, okay? So in true solution, we know the particle size are smaller. So in that case, the particles can pass through or filter through normal filter paper we can use for filtering. But if you are coming to colloids, it can pass through the filter paper, but it cannot pass through the animal membrane. We know semi-permeable membrane and all we used in solution chapter. So in that case, in the animal membrane, the holes or pores present in that membranes are smaller than normal filter paper. So that is why through normal filter paper we can pass which one? Colloidal solution, but not through the animal membrane. Okay, because little bit the pores are small in animal membrane. Okay, then suspension. Suspension means what? The particles are larger than true solution and colloid. So, it cannot pass through filter paper and also which one? Animal membrane. Okay, that is filterability. Then third property is visibility. Visibility means depending upon the size it will be, right? So, we know the true solutions are very small compared to colloids and suspension. So, it is not visible through ultra microscope. If you are using ultra microscope also, we cannot see which particles, true solutions, particles. Okay. But in colloids, what is there, there means we can see, because colloids are little bit, particles are little bit larger than true solution. So, the colloidal particles we can observe through which one? Ultra microscope. Okay. In suspension, suspension particles are larger, so directly we can visible which one? The suspension particles. Okay, that is visibility. Next is appearance. Appearance means, here it is, what is the meaning of appearance means? Whether the solution is transparent, that means through that solution we can see anything, okay, that is transparent or non-transparent or opaque, opaque means what? It is not transparent. Okay. So we know true solutions. In true solution, the particle size is very small, so it is transparent. Okay. Suppose this vessel, one vessel, it is containing a true solution. So through that we can see anything is there. Okay. That means it is transparent because the particle size is small. Colloids means what? It is semi-transparent. It is not very clear transparent like true solution, but it is semi-transparent. Okay. But suspensions means what? Particle size is larger, so it is which one? Opaque. Opaque means what? It is not transparent. Okay, so that is the general properties of true solutions, colloids and suspension. Okay, so next we have to discuss more about our colloids. Okay, because the colloids are in these key, we have to learn more about the colloids. Okay. So what are colloids? We know the particle size for colloids is what? In between 1 to 1000 nanometer, right? So colloids means it is a heterogeneous system. Heterogeneous system means what? It is containing two different phases, right? Okay, so it is a heterogeneous system, consists of two different phases. Phases means what? Two different states or two different components. Okay, and the first component present in the colloid is known as dispersion medium or continuous phase. What is the dispersion phase? Dispersion medium or continuous phase. Okay, so dispersion medium or continuous phase means it is a component of which one? The colloidal system, in which it is a continuous phase or continuous state of the colloidal system, in which the colloidal particles are dispersed. Just like we can say, simply we can say, in a solution, okay, solvent is there and solute is there, right? Okay, so in that solvent is the continuous phase, in that which is dissolved solute, right? So here we can use a different term like that. What is a continuous dispersion medium or continuous phase means it is a continuous medium. It is a medium, okay, in which the colloidal particles are dispersed. Okay, so dispersion medium means it is a medium in which colloidal particles are dispersed. Okay, then next component or next phase is dispersed phase. Okay, dispersion medium or continuous phase. Here it is dispersed phase. Dispersed phase means it is the discontinuous part or discontinuous phase of colloidal particles in a colloidal system. Okay, so colloid means it containing two phases, dispersion medium and dispersion phase. Dispersion medium means that medium, okay, dispersion phase, that colloidal particles. Okay, so colloidal particles are dispersed in dispersion medium. Okay, so two parts are there, dispersion medium and dispersion phase. So dispersion medium is not usually is the continuous medium or continuous phase in which the discontinuous colloidal particles are dispersed. Okay, so generally the examples for colloidal particles are emulsions, gel, clouds, smoke, fog, etc. Many examples are there. So this is one or two examples: emulsions, gel, cloud, etc. So clear all of you the general classification of mixture of substances, and in that the colloid, it is having two different phases. We are moving to the classification of colloids. Okay, colloids are mainly having three types of classification. First classification is based on the physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium. That means depending upon if the dispersion phase is liquid, what is the name of that colloid, like that. Okay. Second is the force of attraction, depending on the force of attraction between the dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Okay. Then third is depending upon the size of dispersion phase, that means size of the colloidal particle. Okay, so first we will move to based on physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium. For dispersion phase, I wrote in short DP, and dispersion medium, it is DM. Okay, so mainly based on the physical state, there are 8 types of classification is there. 8 types are there. Okay, how it is means, first it is given dispersion phase, DP. Dispersion phase means all of you know it is the colloidal particle present in that. Okay, dispersion medium means that is the medium inside that this dispersion phase or colloidal particles are dissolved. Okay, Then what is the name of the colloid? The example. Okay. So first one is gas. First is dispersion phase. Dispersion phase means here the colloidal particle is gas and dispersion medium is liquid. That means gas is dissolved in liquid. Gas is the particle and it is dissolved in which is the medium? Liquid. Okay. So what is the name of that colloid form? You know that foam rubber, foam cushions and all we were using. No. So that means what? Liquid inside the gas. Dispersion phase means what? Gas. Okay. So colloidal particle is gas. Gas is dissolved in liquid. Okay. What is the name of that colloid? Form. Okay. Example, whipped cream and soap lather, etc. If you are checking soap lather, what is happening? It is the lather. Lather means what? That is liquid is there. Outside that is liquid and inside what is there? Gas. Okay. So gas is dissolved in liquid. So that is many examples are there. One or two examples you can say. So whipped cream. Okay. And then soap lather is the example. Second is gas solid. That means here gas is the dissipation phase and solid is the dissipation medium. Means gas is dissolved in solid. How it is gas is dissolved in solid? What is the name of that solid? Sol. S-O-L. What is the name of that colloid? Solid. Sol. For example, pumice stone, foam rubber, etc. are the example. Okay, you know that the pumice stone means all of you know that is a solid. Instead that what is there? Air bubbles are filled. That is pumice stone. Okay. Then foam rubber. That is also you know what is foam rubber. Solid form of the rubber. Instead that what is there? Gas is filled. Okay. So that is an example for the second one. The third one is liquid gas. That means liquid is a dissipation phase. Liquid is dissolved in gas. Liquid is dissolved in gas. Okay, the name of colloid is aerosol of liquid. What is the name of that colloid? Aerosol is aerosol of colloid. Example, fog, mist, cloud. How it will be fog and mist, etc. Fog means what? It is a gas particle. Okay, gas particle inside what is there? Moist content is there. Okay, so gas molecule inside that moist content is there. So that is the fog. Okay, like that mist also. Any two examples you can learn, no problem to learn, no compulsory to learn all the examples. Then liquid and liquid, how it is? Both dissipation phase and dissipation medium is liquid. That is liquid is dissolved in other liquid. What is the name of that colloid? It is emulsion. What is the name of that colloid? It is emulsion. For example, milk. If you are checking milk, means how it is? Milk is contained protein, vitamins, etc. Everything is there, carbohydrates, etc. It is a balanced diet. If you are checking that milk, you can't see that proteins, everything separate. Okay. They are in which form? Liquid form. So liquid mixed and water also there, right? Okay. So liquid in liquid. Okay. So that is example. Then cod liver oil. Cod liver oil means it is an oil or essential oil or essential component that is we will obtain from the liver of some fishes. Okay, fish capsule and all we were taking for minerals, for getting mineral. Okay, so that is cod liver oil. Okay, it is obtained from an liver of one particular type of fish. Okay, in that also what is the proteins and the minerals are dissolved in the form of liquid in liquid. Okay, then liquid solid, that means what? Here liquid is a dissipation phase, liquid is dissolved in solid. Liquid is dissolved in solid. Okay, for example, what is the name of that gel? What is the name of that gel? Or solid emulsions, we can call it as solid emulsion. Okay, for example, butter, jelly, all of you know, no? So butter and jellies are the examples for which one? Liquid in solid. Next is solid dissolved in gas. Solid is dissolved in gas. What is the name of that? Aerosol of solid. What is the name of that? Aerosol of solid. Example, smoke, dust, etc. What is that? Smoke and dust. Dust is the example for each one. Solid in gas. Then, solid in liquid. Solid is dissolved in liquid and it is known as sol. What is the name of it? Sol. Example, starch, paint, etc. Then solid solid. Solid is dissolving solid, but it is known as solid salt. Solid salt means two solids are mixed. How it will be? Alloys and all. Alloys means what? It is a mixture of two metals. Metals are solid, two solids. Okay. Then ruby glass. Ruby glass means what? Means it is a glass. It is obtained by mixing colloid, gold colloid or colloidal gold means what? Gold dissolved in some liquids is mixed with molten glass. So here gold is also solid and molten glass is also solid. So that is why it is solid in solid. Okay. So based on the physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium, 8 types of colloids we got. Okay. So these are the 8 types. In this, you have to, you can learn some examples, not compulsory to learn all the examples, okay? One or two examples for each one you can learn. So clear all of you, the first classification based on physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Classification is based on the interaction between dispersion phase and dispersion medium. First was based on the physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Second is based on interaction between dispersion phase and dispersion medium. And it is very important. Classification, this is more important. Okay. So based on the interaction between dispersion phase and dispersion medium, there are two types of colloids. That is lyophilic colloids. Lyophilic. P-H-I-L-L-I-C. Lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids. Okay. So, two types are there. Lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids. Okay. Lyophilic colloids means the interaction. Lyo means the, what is the meaning of lyo? L-Y-O. Lyo means it is solvent. Philic means it is loving. Okay. Lyo means, what is the meaning of lyo? Lyo means solvent. Philic means loving. That means it is a solvent loving colloid. Okay. That means there is a strong affinity between the solvent. That means dispersion. Which one is the solvent here? Dispersion medium and dispersion phase. Okay. So lyophilic colloids means there will be a large affinity, means large attraction, okay, between the lyophilic, like between the dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Okay, so that type of colloids are known as what? Lyophilic colloids. Okay, and lyophilic colloids are very stable. Okay, very stable, and it is not easy to coagulate them. Okay, we have to add more electrolytes to coagulate that. Okay, and it is reversible. Reversible means what? If it is precipitated, that means by means of evaporation, if you remove the dispersion medium is the solvent, right? Okay, then we will get the precipitate of colloidal particle, right? So if we again we are adding the dispersion medium or solvent, we can regenerate that colloid. That means it is reversible. Okay, reversible means it can be converted to a precipitate or it can be coagulated, but by the removal of dispersion medium. But if you are, once again, if you are adding the dispersion medium, we will get the colloid. Okay, so that is why it is reversible and it is very stable. Okay, because it is loving species, solvent loving. So there is a great affinity or great attraction between the dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Okay, and the example for lyophilic colloids are starch, gelatin, insulin, gum, etc. Starch is starch, gelatin. Many examples, starch, gelatin, insulin, gum, etc. are the examples of which one? Lyophilic. Okay. Then lyophobic. Lyophobic means it is opposite of lyophilic. Lyo means it solvent. Phobic means hating. Okay. That means it is solvent hating colloid. So there is no greater affinity between dispersion phase and dispersion medium. So there is no much affinity or now much force of interaction between which one? The lyo, which one? The DP and DM, that is dispersion phase and dispersion medium. So that is why they are unstable. They are not very stable like lyophilic, and it is irreversible. What is the meaning of irreversible? Means once the lyophobic colloid is precipitated or coagulated, after that if you are adding the dissipation medium or the solvent, we cannot regenerate the colloid. Once if it is precipitated, means it is precipitated only, so we cannot regenerate that colloid by adding the dissipation medium. So that is why it is irreversible. Clear? So that is lyophobic and lyophilic. Okay, the difference between lyophobic and lyophilic, it is very easy. You can easily get 3 marks. They will ask for this year also. They ask, write any 3 difference between lyophobic and lyophilic colloids. Okay, in textbook it is, I think, around 10 differences are given. In that, which one is the easy difference? You can learn that one. So here it is mentioned that differences. First one is lyophilic. It is very easy to prepare. Okay, it is formed by direct mixing of dissipation phase and dissipation medium. We will get lyophilic colloids. That means because they are loving species, that means both are having much affinity. That is, the colloidal particle or dissipation phase is having more affinity towards the dissipation medium. So they are just mixing, they will form which one? Colloids. That is lyophilic. Lyophobic means it is not solvent loving. That means the dissipation phase is not having very much affinity towards the dissipation medium. That is why we have to apply specific methods for the preparation of lyophobic colloids. Then, second, I already told you, lyophilic is reversible. Reversible means what? Once if it is precipitated also, if you are adding the dissipation medium, we can regenerate the lyophilic colloid. But lyophobic means it is irreversible. We cannot regenerate the lyophobic colloid by adding the dissipation medium. Then third is, the lyophilic colloids is not visible under microscope. That means it is very small. But lyophobic means it is visible under the microscope. Compared to lyophilic, lyophobic is larger. Then stable, I already told you, lyophilic colloids means the great affinity. So that is why they are stable. And lyophobic means this is unstable. Then for lyophilic, because it is already stable, so large amount of the electrolyte or other substance is needed for the coagulation or precipitation of which one? Lyophilic, because they are stable. But lyophobic means they are already unstable. Okay, so they don't like the dissipation phase and dissipation medium very much. So that is why if you are adding a small amount of any type of electrolyte, it is easily to coagulate or precipitate lyophobic. Then the coagulation then may or may not carry charge. That means this one, lyophilic colloids particles, that means dissipation phase, may or may not carry electric charge. It is not compulsory. It is we cannot say that some of the colloidal particles may carry, some of them they don't carry the electric charge. But in lyophobic means they will carry the electric charge. That is the difference. Then seventh point is lyophilic is highly solvated. Why it is highly solvated? Because there is a great affinity between the dissipation medium and dissipation phase. Okay, so phase love, that is dissipation medium, that means dissipation solvent. So there is, it is highly solvated. But lyophobic means it is solvent loving. So it is appreciably which one? Solvent. That means there is not much dissipation medium will be there in the lyophobic. Okay, may or may not show Tyndall effect. Okay, it's very important. It's one of the property of colloidal particle. It is coming in the next topic, next class it is coming. What is Tyndall effect and all? So I will explain what is Tyndall effect, because it is a compulsory question. Okay, so now you have to know only the name Tyndall effect. That means lyophilic colloids, they may or may not show which effect? Tyndall effect. Okay, but lyophobic means they shows Tyndall effect. Then next one is solvent loving. Many times I told they are lyophilic means solvent loving, and lyophobic means what? Solvent hating. Okay, then last the example also I told. Example for lyophobic colloid is, it is the colloids formed from a metal and its metal compounds, like a metal mixed with what? Metal sulfides and metal oxides, etc. So mainly lyophobic means it is a colloid formed by the metals and its compounds, metal compounds, okay, like metal and metal oxide or metal sulfide, that mixture, for example, lyophobic. So here many differences are there. So any three difference maximum they will ask for 3 mark question. So any easy three difference you can learn. So it is easy to score 3 marks. So clear all of you what is lyophobic colloids definition and lyophilic colloid definition and the difference between lyophobic and lyophilic colloids. Classification is based on the type of particles of dispersion phase. Dispersion phase means there is a colloidal particles, okay, depending upon the type of these particles, okay, the classification. First one is multimolecular classification, multimolecular colloids. Second one is macromolecular colloids. And the third one is associated colloids or micelles. This is very important. What is the other name? Micelles. Okay, so based on the type of particles of colloidal particles of dispersion phase, okay, generally multimolecular, macromolecular and associated colloids. Okay, so multimolecular means the name itself, it is there, large number of colloidal particles. Colloidal particle means what? Dispersion phase. Aggregate means what? Joined together to form the colloids. That is why it is known as multimolecular colloids. Okay, so example for multimolecular colloids means it is gold salt, sulfur salt, etc. Okay, gold salt means what? Gold salt is formed by joining or aggregating large number of gold particles. Okay, then sulfur salt means sulfur salt is formed by aggregating or joining together large number of S8, that is sulfur, allotrope of sulfur molecule. Okay, so that is large number is important in multimolecular. Okay, then macromolecular means what? Large sized, that is why it is macro. Macro means large. Okay, so large sized colloidal particles are dispersed in dispersion medium, we will get macromolecular colloids. Macromolecular, large sized. Okay, so that is why it is macro. Example for naturally occurring macromolecular colloids are proteins, enzymes, etc. Artificially we can prepare, that is synthetic, means it is polyurethane, that is a polymer, we will discuss in polymer chapter. Then PVA, PVA means polyvinyl acetate, that is also example for polymer. So it is macromolecular colloid. Okay, then next is associated colloids or micelles. It is very important in this classification. Associated colloids or micelles means some substances on dissolution or dissolving in any solvent, okay, at a lower concentration they will be behaving as normal electrolyte. Okay, so at lower, for some substances on dissolution in solvent, they will behave as normal electrolyte at lower concentration. But at higher concentration, they will act as a colloid due to the aggregation of the particles. Okay, but they are known as associated colloids. So what is associated colloids? At lower, some substances on dissolution at lower concentration behaves as normal electrolyte. Okay, but at the higher concentration, they will behave as colloids due to the aggregation of colloidal particles. They are known as associated colloids or micelles. Okay, at higher concentration, what will happen means the van der Waals force of attraction become more, because concentration is more, no? So the van der Waals force of attraction between the dispersion phase and dispersion medium will be more. That is why they will aggregate and form the associated colloids. Okay, then in this now two things you have to know in associated colloids. Okay, at higher concentration only they will behave as the colloids, right? Okay, the concentration above which the formation of associated colloids taking place. Okay, so what is that? The concentration above which the formation of associated colloids or micelles taking place is known as CMC or critical missiles concentration. So what is critical missile concentration? So what is CMC or critical missile concentration? The concentration above which the formation of missiles or associated colloids taking place is known as what? Critical missiles concentration or CMC. So that particular concentration only what will form our associated colloid or missiles. From below that it won't form which one? The colloid. Okay, so the concentration at which or above which the formation of missiles or associated colloids taking place is known as what? Critical missiles concentration. Okay, then next is craft temperature. Craft temperature, okay, CAFT. Craft temperature means it is the temperature TK. It is the temperature above which the missiles formation taking place. That temperature is known as what? Critical missiles temperature. It's known as critical, not critical, craft temperature. That is TK, clear? Okay. So critical missiles concentration or CMC means that concentration over which missiles formation taking place, right? Craft temperature, K-R-A-F-T, craft temperature, that is TK means what? The temperature above which the formation of missiles taking place. That temperature is known as what? Craft temperature, okay? Below that temperature, what won't be there? What formation, the missiles formation does not takes place, okay? So, craft, K-R-A-F-T, not C-R-A-F-T, craft temperature, that is TK. Okay. Example for associated colloids or missiles colloids is soaps and detergents in water. Okay. If you are dissolving soaps and detergents in water at higher concentration, they will behave as the missiles. Okay. The CMC, that is critical missiles concentration for soaps and detergents, is found to be 10⁻⁴ to 10⁻³ moles per liter. Okay, that means what? Moles per liter. That means that much molarity or that much concentration should be there, minimum 10⁻⁴ to 10⁻³. Otherwise, what will not be formed? The missiles will be formed for soaps and detergents. So, soaps and detergents in water is the best example for associated colloids or missiles. Okay, so in associated colloids, CMC, critical missiles concentration, and craft temperature is important. Okay, so multimolecular means it is large number of colloidal particles aggregate to form. Macromolecule means large sized colloidal particles aggregate to form. Associated or missiles means what? At lower concentration, no colloids, but after a particular concentration, that is at higher concentration, they will behave as the colloid. Okay. Then the difference, first difference we talk, large number, large size, then at higher concentration. Then one more difference is there, we can lyophobic. Multimolecular colloids are lyophobic, then macromolecular colloids are lyophilic, and associated can act as both, which one? Lyophobic and lyophilic. Okay. Then for in multimolecular, molecular mass is intermediate. That means it is not too high molecular mass for that colloids and too low, intermediate molecular mass. But macromolecules means we know large sized molecules are combining, no, aggregating. So it is having high molecular mass. Associated also having high molecular mass. Okay. Then in multimolecular, the weak van der Waals force of attraction will be there in between dispersion phase and dispersion medium. But in macromolecular, strong van der Waals force of attraction is there. And in associated colloids also, what there? Strong van der Waals force of attraction will be there. Okay. So that is about the classification of colloids. So today's class, we discuss the main classification of colloids. Okay. Based on the physical state of dispersion phase and dispersion medium. Then based on the force of attraction between dispersion phase and dispersion medium. That is very important. Lyophobic and lyophilic. After that, based on the type of particles of the dispersion phase, in that the associated colloids or missiles are important, and craft temperature and critical missile concentration is also very important. Okay, so that is about today's class. Thank you, girls.